Yeah, so this is part two. Oh yeah, and I forgot to name the title of the video. You already see below and shit. The name of the title of the video is I'm trying to think, but you already see it. Let me think. What's the name of the video? You already know, but I don't know. I'm making a video. It's not live. I'm just making a video, so I need to. Let me think. Christmas is evil and satanic. That's the name of the topic. So this whole topic is Christmas is evil and satanic part two. That's the name of it. Christmas is evil and satanic part two. This is part two right now. So you already seen it. You already know before I was talking about it. I didn't know, but because I'm taping it. Me taping this, this is the events before you've seen it. But anyways. Let me go to Isaiah chapter Let me find it. I got a lot of time on my hands, so I'm going to find it. Let me see. I know where it was. Isaiah, I think it was Isaiah chapter 1 verse. Let me see here. Here we go. Let's go. All right. So I'm gonna read from Isaiah. I'm going in the Bible. End of the day, I'm not no pastor. I'm not no prophet. I'm a man of God. That's it. Just trying to get to the Bible and read a little scriptures to you and stuff. So this is Isaiah. This is Isaiah chapter 1 verse. I'm going from 14 verse 14 and 15. All right, so it says, all right, hold on one sec. Yes, I'm gonna go from verse 14 to 15. So yeah, it says in verse 14, your new moons and your appointed feast, my soul hates. They are a trouble to me. I am weary of bearing them. When you spread out your hands, I will hide my eyes from you. Even though you make many prayers, I will not hear your. I will not hear. Your hands are full of blood. So basically, what it's saying, from that scripture, at least from what I know, is that it's talking about when the people who celebrating. These holidays, like Thanksgiving, they celebrated a month ago, and then from there was Christmas. Now they're under this fucking spell now, and the church is under that spell too, where they got Christmas trees and all this stuff. And even when you tell these people and stuff, what they're gonna say? They go like, oh well, we're just this is just remembrance of Christ being born. Okay, but the end of the day, Christ wasn't born on this day. So what are you trying to tell me? What are you trying to say? Cause basically you just trying to make up some excuse to try to, basically if you tell them to repent from taking part in this, all they're going to say, I'm just taking part and just trying to be in the holiday spirit. That's an excuse and shit. That's a fucking excuse that's gonna come out of these motherfuckers' mouths and shit, man. They know, and you see, they probably know, the pastor probably know this scripture and shit, but yet he probably don't want to go in the scripture and tell these people that. He don't want to tell them to repent and turn away from these holidays. But no, they're going to sing their Christmas carols, and they're going to, they're going to sing all their Christmas carols, they're going to try to be in the holiday spirit, they're going to bring their gifts, they're going to give the kids gifts and shit. Instead of telling them to repent and turn away from their sins to make it to the kingdom, they ain't telling them that. They're only telling them bullshit and lies and manipulations, only to confuse them more and more and more each year and each lifetime. You know what I mean? But yeah, they going fucking, these motherfuckers, they just, you know, they just, you know, They like to play games, and then when they go, they may act nice. They may show this little nice image of them. They may show this little nice image of them. I'm trying to get my tea right now. They may show that nice image of themselves, but the truth of the matter is, you know, that's not what they really are. Cause then behind closed doors, they got this evil look. It's like, deceive these people and all that stuff. That's all these motherfuckers are, especially some of these pastors. I'm not saying every pastor. They got some pastors preaching against this stuff. And salute to the pastors who's preaching against Christmas. Who's against Christmas. Who's preaching the word and telling the people that Christmas is nothing but a satanic holiday, and the people need to repent. Salute to the pastors that's preaching against Christmas. But the ones who's not preaching against it, look, you go. The ones who's not preaching against it, and the ones who's taking part, the pastors who's taking part in Christmas. Look, the Most High gonna deal with y'all. Just know that. I don't give a fuck how you gonna feel. Take it anyway. I don't give a shit. I really don't give a fuck. You know what I mean? I'm here to spread His truth. You know what I mean? I'm here to spread His truth. Look, just know, and y'all better repent too. You better repent. Cause you don't repent, I'm not judging, but the Most High judges. So just repent. That's it. You know what I mean? But just know I'm fed up with the shit and the manipulation y'all try to pull on the people and stuff. Y'all basically know the whole word and stuff. Why the fuck can you all explain the word to the people and stop manipulating and stop having this fucking smoke and mirror in the fucking church? Know the fuck I'm saying? Back to what I was talking about now. Now I just get fed up with these motherfuckers, these warlock pastors. I always trying to manipulate people and try to fucking get them in a spell and stuff. This, with all this, you know, hoping and all this dumb shit they do and shit. That's not how a pastor should be. A pastor's supposed to be in the Bible and reading scriptures to the people, telling the people to repent from their sins, turn away from their sins. Not saying, oh, the Most High going to forgive you for your sins. The pastor can't just keep saying, if as long as you repent, you'll be saved. Look, we're not saved until, you know, the end. He who endures to the end shall be saved. Don't keep going on a pulpit and telling people, as long as you repent, then you're good. No, man, you got to tell them to turn away from their sins. You got to tell them to repent. You gotta tell them to not to sin again. Just tell them if they constantly sin and they constantly sin, they're gonna probably be in the lake of fire if they keep sinning, if they're not turned away from their sins. Now it's harsh, but it's the truth. The Most High wants us to turn away from our sins. At the end of the day, we're angels having a human experience, but the thing is, we're fighting the demons within us. And we have to fight that demon within us in order to become the angel we were meant to be. But nah, the pastor ain't want to tell you. They only want to tell you something. I'm only on this part telling you what I'm telling you is because this is the shit that goes on in church. They want to keep you down in this low frequency. They don't want you to become that angel that the Most High wants you to be. They want you to be these warlocks and witches that go up in there, want you to be. They just want you to stay in your demonic state, your demon state. When you shouldn't be at that demon state. We're made in God's image, and we're angels. We're angels having a human experience right now. Any pastor who takes part in Christmas and is offended what I'm saying, I don't give a fuck. I don't give a fuck. I really do not give a fuck. Anyways. But the pastors who's against Christmas and don't like Christmas and hates Christmas, salute. I respect y'all. I respect that y'all preaching the true word and the truth. Now, back to I'm gonna go to another verse real quick. I'm just only reading two verses and stuff. Oh, the Tim and Mar. I'm going to listen to no.